David Finch, al Napoli Comico, un grandissimo autore americano, partito con la Top Cow e poi passato ai grandi personaggi mainstream della Marvel e della DC, attualmente attivo su Batman, dopo il reboot che ha rivisto le origini di tutto il DC Universe. Batman, un personaggio che ha 75 anni, nasce nell'era pulp, ma sopravvive a tutti gli eroi pulp e diventa un successo mondiale ancora oggi. David ci dice il suo punto di vista sul successo di Batman.
I think Batman has really lived on beyond a lot of pulp heroes that have kind of faded because first of all, the costume is so iconic and so immediately recognizable, and it's something that most characters really don't have. I think even in a silhouette, you can tell Batman a mile away. And he's also a character that can be cartoony and can be very serious and can be very dark, and to have a whole range in between is very, very versatile, and I think that's really helped him live on. And I really think that Batman has his roots really in pulp heroes, and there's so much great material that I think is kind of long forgotten, and the fact that Batman was drawn graphically, I think it really connected with a younger reader that maybe pulp heroes kind of were starting to lose at the time. And so I think it was a real crossover, and you know, I think it really carried the flavor of what was so great about the pulp books, you know, back in the day.
Il costume di Batman della ripartenza del DC Universe è stato ideato da Jim Lee, uno dei grandissimi maestri del fumetto iperdinamico americano, ma anche David è uno dei nuovi maestri del fumetto iperdinamico americano. Che energia hai dato al costume e alle azioni di Batman mentre lo disegni?
I think Jim Lee's costume is phenomenal, and you know, again, it's a real testament to just how versatile Batman's costume can be. I know for me, when I'm drawing Batman, I tend to simplify a little bit. I like the real classic, you know, more muscular look, and I have a very difficult time drawing something that's very geometrical and you know, very armored. So it's a bit of an amalgam for me when I draw him. I love how Jim Lee draws him, and he looks more, he's very hard edged, and he looks like he would cut you if you touched him, and I think that's great. For me, I like something that's a little bit more, you know, fabric and tactile, you know, so that's, I'm really trying to draw a balance between those two feels.
In un ciclo di storie recente, David non solo ha disegnato Batman, ma anche ha ideato e scritto e sceneggiato la storia. Gli chiediamo come ha affrontato questa particolare sfida.
I had a real vision for what I wanted Batman to be. So writing the comic was a way for me to really get across exactly the kind of Batman experience I wanted to be able to put on the page. It was very, very important to me starting out. And I think I had a great experience with it. It was incredibly difficult, more difficult than I really gave it credit for when I started. So I'm actually working with Greg Hurwitz now. He's a novelist and a TV producer and a phenomenal writer. And he's already written the first six issues of our first arc together. And it is such a relief to work with such a great professional and know that I have a story that I can be proud of and be able to just jump into the artwork and try and bring his story to life. And it's something I think I really appreciate more now that I've had the experience of writing. You know, Top Cow and the Image, when it came out, was a real breath of fresh air after many, many years of really the same superheroes coming from Marvel and DC, and a lot of great ideas came from that, and there have been movies, and there have been cartoons, and toys, and a lot of things that are still really living on from those characters, but we have an audience that I think is really reliving their youth through superheroes and through superhero comics. So that's really kind of brought back the importance of Batman and Superman and Wonder Woman and, you know, Spider-Man and all those characters. And they've really kind of become dominant again. But I think Image really proved that if some great artists and great writers get together and produce something special, there's room for that in the audience. And I think that time is going to come again. You know, I think it's very difficult to sustain against characters that really have so much history and live on, like, you know, Batman and Superman. But it is possible to come in and really create something new and, you know, and something fresh for a period of time. And hopefully maybe create something that'll live on. Actually, for me, I'm while I'm doing Batman for DC, I'm actually planning a creator-owned comic myself right now that I'm looking at potentially Image to publish, or actually maybe Top Cow, and talking to a few people. It's called Volto, and it's actually my writing partner is Italian, so it's very based on a lot of, especially Venetian history and that kind of thing. It's a futuristic story, but I'm really excited about it. And yeah, I think it's a great question because that's my roots, you know, creating things, you know, kind of from scratch. And it was for me, it was a dream come true to come to Marvel when I did years ago, because I grew up on those characters. But my start is really just creating and coming up with things. So I'm really looking forward to kind of getting back to that a little bit and kind of, you know, trying to create something new.